إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا بربوبيته وإرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر، كل من عليها فان، ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقائدنا وقرة أعيننا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون ولو كره المشركون، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. أما بعد عباد الله، فإني أوصيكم ونفسي المخطئة بتقوى الله، وأحثكم على طاعته، وأحذركم مبال عصيانه ومخالفة أمره. فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره، ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. يقول الله تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and peace be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that there is no God except Allah, and I testify that Muhammad is the prophet and the messenger of Allah, and I encourage myself and you to fear none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah azza wa jal, your Lord, states in the Holy Quran: all those who believe, fear Allah the way He should be feared, and do not die unless you are in the state of Islam. My brothers in Islam, as the month of Ramadan had ended, and we start a new month, the month of Shawwal, a blessed month, the most blessed month throughout the entire year that we've experienced in fasting during the day and in prayers during the night. A month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us all to be from amongst those that experience it. A month that carried many blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that carried the mercy of Allah, the forgiveness of Allah, that carried a great blessing and grace from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us all. But now that month had ended for us to start a new month. And that month is the month of fasting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in the Qur'an al-Kareem: يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All those who believe, Allah had prescribed upon you the month of Ramadan, the month of fasting. He had prescribed upon you to fast in the month of Ramadan the way He did on the previous nations before you. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so you could acquire taqwa. And yes, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we did fast the month of Ramadan. But then I want to remind you of another verse in the Quran al-Kareem in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will only accept from those who have taqwa and acquired taqwa. So now, alhamdulillah, we did fast in the month of Ramadan. And we did strive in the month of Ramadan. And we did sacrifice in the month of Ramadan. But now the most important question that we need to ask ourselves: did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting in the month of Ramadan, in which I ask Allah azza wa jal that He did accept our worship in the month of Ramadan? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in the Quran al-Kareem, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will only accept from the muttaqeen, from the pious ones. So if our fasting did not have taqwa in it, well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it clear, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah azza wa jal only accepts from those who have taqwa. So if our fasting did not have taqwa, then there is a big possibility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not even accept our fasting. إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only accepts from the muttaqeen, from the pious and the righteous ones. For that, my brothers in Islam, did we acquire taqwa in the month of Ramadan? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would accept our fasting in the month of Ramadan for what's after the month of Ramadan. And I know a lot of people, and none of us in reality can even answer that question, did Allah accept my fasting or not? Because we do not see the records of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can't see the books of Allah azza wa jal. We don't have access to the records and the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there are indications that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us that indicates that He did accept our fasting or not. Number one indication is your connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's been 3 days already after the end of the month of Ramadan. It's been 3 days after the month of Ramadan now. You need to ask yourself, is your connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the same or better after the month of Ramadan as it was in the month of Ramadan? Or did you find yourself already losing that connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Already a number of people told me, Shaykh, I've already lost that connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I feel already disconnected. I don't feel that connection with Allah azza wa jal. In the month of Ramadan, I was on the high with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I felt that true connection with Allah azza wa jal. I felt that true close relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the true close connection with Allah Almighty. But now after the month of Ramadan, we start feeling that decline of that relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal. We start feeling that relationship start to diminish or start to reduce. So not having or not feeling that sentiment or that connection with Allah Azza wa Jal as you felt it in the month of Ramadan is not a good sign of the connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's acceptance. That's number one. Number two, feeling of upset that the month of Ramadan did end, not the feeling of joy and happiness that the month of Ramadan did end. What am I trying to say? What I'm trying to say, my brothers in Islam, yes, alhamdulillah, we feel happy that the day of Eid had come. And we feel happy that, alhamdulillah, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when you come out of a month that's full of the blessings of Allah azza wa jal, when you come out of a month, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had promised in that month, He did not promise in any other month. And you come out of it happy, not coming out of it sad, that I'm gonna miss out on so much goodness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed in the month of Ramadan. That's not a sign of righteousness. Because the believers look forward to the times and occasions of worship. We look forward to that time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us extra. And you find that sentiment that's widely spread amongst Muslims, that when the month of Ramadan ends, they are happy. I'm not talking about that type of happiness that they are happy about the day of Eid, or they are happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed them of the month of Ramadan, but they are happy that the month of fasting had ended. You shouldn't be happy that the month of fasting had ended. Why should you be happy that the month of fasting had ended? The month of rahmah, the month of mercy, the month of blessing, the month of grace had ended. Here we are, we've experienced the month of Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what He gives in the month of Ramadan, He does not give it any other month. There's no need for us, and there's no reason for us to be happy that the month of Ramadan had ended. We should be sad. We should be sad that the month of Ramadan had ended. We should be upset that the month of Ramadan had ended. Because what you get in the month of Ramadan, you will never ever get any other month. You will never ever acquire any other month. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us to be from amongst those that experienced the month of Ramadan. For that, we need to be sad. I am sad that the month of Ramadan had ended. I am upset that the month of Ramadan had ended. What I'm going to do in 1 month, I could have done it in 1 hour, and Allah Azza wa Jalla gives me the same rewards in the month of Ramadan. So another sign of acquiring taqwa in the month of Ramadan is that you are upset that the month of Ramadan had ended. And that's the sign of our predecessors. That's the quality of our predecessors. Our predecessors used to be sad when the month of Ramadan used to end. And now you find the vast majority of Muslims are happy when the month of Ramadan had ended. And again, don't get me wrong. I am not referring to the happiness of the day of Eid and alhamdulillah we get together and we glorify Allah Azza wa Jal. I am referring that people are really happy that they're no longer fasting anymore. We're not fasting anymore. Alhamdulillah. It's over now. How many times you've heard that the past few days? Finally the month of Ramadan is over. Happy over what? Happy over what? That you're no longer getting the rewards that you were getting in the month of Ramadan. You are no longer getting the blessings that you used to get in the month of Ramadan. You are no longer getting the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah Azza wa Jalla that you were getting in the month of Ramadan. Happy for what? Yes, we are happy that the day of Eid had come. And yes, we are happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us experience the month of Ramadan. But I'm not happy that the month of Ramadan had ended. Because if we really had true taqwa, would have hoped and wished that the entire year and our life is Ramadan. That's taqwa. Would have hoped and wished that our entire life and every day of our life is the month of Ramadan. If we knew what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives in the month of Ramadan. So that's another sign of acquiring taqwa. That's another indication of acquiring taqwa in the month of Ramadan. That right now, you are sad that the month of Ramadan had ended. You are upset that the month of Ramadan had ended. You are so upset that the month of Ramadan had ended that you can't even wait for the next Ramadan to come. And that's the third indication of taqwa. You are looking forward to next year's Ramadan already. From now, even though we're 11 months apart from the next Ramadan, but you are so looking forward to next year's Ramadan. And not only that, but you're also preparing for next year's Ramadan. I know it sounds too drastic for us to start thinking about it, but that's the reality. We are already planning and preparing ourselves for next year's Ramadan. That's another indication of taqwa. That I'm looking forward to next year's Ramadan and I am preparing for next year's Ramadan. That's the quality of our predecessors. That's the quality and the trait of the true believers. Those who acquire taqwa. Those who acquire piety and righteousness. The fourth indication, my brothers in Islam, is that you continue to raise your hands to Allah Azza wa Jalla to accept your fasting. You supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He accepts your fasting. The past 3 days, how many of us raised their hands to Allah and said, Ya Rab, taqabbal minni siyami, Ya Allah, accept my fasting. How many of us did that? Maybe that's not even included in our dua. We've been making dua, Ya Allah, forgive us, have mercy upon us, Ya Allah, grant me wealth, Ya Allah, if I'm not married, Ya Allah, find me a good wife, Ya Allah, this, Ya Allah, that, Ya Allah, increase my wealth, give me a job. But how many of us really raised their hands to Allah and said, Ya Rab, oh Allah, I ask you that you accept my fasting in the month of Ramadan. That should be part of your dua from now to next year's Ramadan. Because that's the quality of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum and the quality of our predecessors. That they'll continue to ask Allah Azza wa Jal to accept their fasting to the following Ramadan, to the next Ramadan. Oh Allah, accept my fasting. Oh Allah, ask you to accept my fasting in the month of Ramadan. Because the worst thing that we could ever bring upon ourselves is that after we fasted in the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not even accept our fasting. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He says the worst of people in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those who pray like us, they fast like us, they are from amongst us. You find them from face value, from the outside. They are very righteous people. But then the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam describes them to be, إِنَّ hereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn all their good deeds into a dust in the air. Nothing. Why, O Messenger of Allah? Because they were the type of people. They used to worship Allah. They used to fast. They used to pray. They used to do a lot of good deeds. But then when they are alone, they used to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They used to severely disobey Allah azza wa jalla. So from face value, from the outside, these people are righteous people. These people are good people. These people pray, these people fast, these people attend the qiyam, these people do this and they do that. But when they are alone, they disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, in the hereafter they will stand before Allah azza wa jal, and their good deeds will turn into dust in the air. Nothing. All will be discounted. All their good deeds will be discounted. So now it's about us being steadfast. And that's the fifth sign and indication of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting your fasting. Steadfastness. Steadfastness. Al-istiqamah. Steadfastness after the month of Ramadan. That you are steadfast after the month of Ramadan. The way that you were in the month of Ramadan, you are after the month of Ramadan. That's another indication of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting your fasting. And another indication, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting your ibadah. Because one of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting your ibadah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you to continue worshipping Him. When Allah accepts something from you, Allah will increase it within you. When Allah accepts something from you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase it within you. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had accepted your fasting, and Allah azza wa jalla had accepted your worship in the month of Ramadan, then Allah azza wa jalla will increase that within you after the month of Ramadan. That's another important indication. Another important sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had accepted your fasting in the month of Ramadan. Look at your condition. Are you still steadfast the way you were in the month of Ramadan? After the month of Ramadan, it's only 3 days after the month of Ramadan. Only 3 days. Just 3 days ago, it was the month of Ramadan. Now, 3 nights ago, it was the month of Ramadan. 3 days ago, it was the month of Ramadan. We were worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal. We were steadfast. We were on the right path. Now, look at your condition. How many of us already relapsed? How many of us already fall back? How many of us already falling back? Look at your condition. One of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting your fasting in the month of Ramadan is to look at your condition after the month of Ramadan. Are you as you were after the month of Ramadan, as you were in the month of Ramadan? Are you still praying on time? Are you still waking up for Fajr? Are you still getting up for Qiyam? Are you still keeping away from the haram? Are you still doing the right things that you were doing in the month of Ramadan? Are you still keeping away from the wrong things that you kept away from the month of Ramadan? Or you went back to everything that you used to do before the month of Ramadan, after the month of Ramadan? That's not a good sign that Allah Azza wa Jalla had accepted your fasting. إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only accepts from those that fear Him, from those who are righteous, from those who are pious. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only accepts from the muttaqeen. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about steadfastness so much that nothing was so heavy upon him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the commands of Allah azza wa jal as much as steadfastness was heavy upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said himself alayhi salatu wa sallam that the verse that Allah azza wa jal had mentioned in Surah Hud, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتْ, O Muhammad, be steadfast. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had commanded you to be steadfast, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that verse turned my hair grey. It's so heavy upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A lot more heavier than any other verse that's been mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem. That verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam and ordered him and told the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam to be steadfast. Oh Muhammad, be steadfast. Maybe that's a verse that we just pass it so quick. We read it, we know of it, but we pass it so quick. But to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that verse And the lyrics of this verse made the hair of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam get gray because of the heaviness and the severity of that verse. He understood what steadfastness is. Be straight. Be perseverant. Be steadfast on the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. Constantly obey Allah and never disobey Him. Be on the right path and never deviate from it. Be on the right path and never derail. Be on the right path and never deter away from it. 3 days already from the day, from the month of Ramadan. 3 days and already a lot of people are collapsing. Many people are falling. Many people are deviating from the path that we're on in the month of Ramadan. That's not a good sign, my brothers in Islam. That's not a good sign. You want to see the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's acceptance and pleasure upon you. And you'll see that not only within your heart, but within your actions. You'll see that in your a'mal. You'll see that with the path that you are on. You'll see that with the reflection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure upon you. You'll see that, you'll sense that. For that, my brothers in Islam, it's so important for us to look out for those indications that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had accepted our fasting. To be observant of those indications that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did accept my fasting. And for me to be on the path that pleases Allah azza wa jalla and never ever deviate from it. On that path that will continue connecting me to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر. أشكره وهو الذي وعد المزيد لمن شكر. وأصلي وأسلم وأبارك على النبي المعتبر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My brothers in Islam, from amongst the things that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommended us to do after the month of Ramadan is to fast the 6 days of Shawwal, which is the month that comes right after the month of Ramadan, and that's the month that we are all experiencing right now. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever fasts 6 days after the month of Ramadan, as if he had fasted the entire year. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so generous. When Allah rewards, He doesn't reward one or two or three. But whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards, Allah azza wa jal always multiplies His rewards up to 10 times, even up to 700 times in other narrations, and even more than that. So for each day that you had fasted in the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards you the rewards of 10 days. So alhamdulillah, we did fast 30 days in the month of Ramadan, times that by 10, that's 300. And an entire year has 355 days of a lunar year. Not a solar year, lunar year. So you are short of 55 days, so make them up with another 6 days after the month of Ramadan in the month of Shawwal, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards you the rewards of 60 days. So 6 days times 10, that's 60 days, with 30 days times 10, that's 300, 300 plus 60, that's 360. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged us and highly recommended for us that we fast 6 days after the month of Ramadan in the month of Shawwal to complete the entire year of reward. In which you could stand before Allah Azza wa Jalla and say, Ya Allah, I did fast the equivalent of 360 days, the equivalent of what pleases you as an entire year. That's one. The other one is, as some of the scholars say, fasting 6 days after the month of Ramadan, it is also a sign of steadfastness. It is also a sign of steadfastness, that steadfastness that was spoken about before, in the first khutbah. Is that you continue fasting after the month of Ramadan as you were fasting in the month of Ramadan, even though you're only fasting 6 days. So that's another sign of steadfastness. And since it's a sign of steadfastness, it is a sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's acceptance. That Allah azza wa jalla did accept your fasting in the month of Ramadan. For that, my brothers in Islam, I encourage you that you fast 6 days in the month of Shawwal, the month that we are in right now. And you could fast those 6 days the way you want. You could fast them 6 days consecutively. You could fast them one day yes, one day no. You could fast them one day yes, 2 days no, the way you want. There's no restrictions on the way that you fast that 6 days. You could fast that 6 days the way you want. You want to fast them 6 days after each other, 2 days yes, 2 days no, however you want. And you could fast them during any time. You could fast them on Fridays, you could fast them on Saturdays, Sundays. There is no restrictions, because this is a sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it is also a teaching of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam upon us to continue steadfast, to continue to be steadfast after the month of Ramadan, to continue to be perseverant after the month of Ramadan. That's why he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged us to fast 6 days of the month of Shawwal that we're all experiencing now. And you'll get the rewards of an entire year. Allahu Akbar. Where do you get that from? Well, Allah Azza wa Jalla tells you, do one good deed, I'll give you 10 times of the rewards. 10 times the rewards. Where do you get something like that, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, oh my servant, do one good deed, I'll give you 10 times the rewards. I'm not only that, minimum 10 times. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in the hadith al-Qudsi, that Allah Azza wa Jalla says, if my servant intends to do a good deed, I'll record it for him a good deed, even if he doesn't do it. And if he does it, I'll record it for him one good deed, then I'll multiply it up to 10 times, then up to 700 times. My brothers in Islam, look how generous Allah Azza wa Jal is. For every good deed that you do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just multiplies it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to multiply it and multiply it and multiply it. So all you have to do is do little good deeds and see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you in return. Sometimes I think about it. With all this generosity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and kindness from Allah azza wa jal, that Allah azza wa jal gives you for every good deed that you do 10 times up to 700 times. That means you gotta be so bad for you to miss out on the Jannah. You gotta be so evil for you to miss out on the Jannah. If Allah azza wa jal has given you up to 700 times for every good deed that you do, then how is it possible for someone to miss out on the Jannah? All you have to do is so little good deeds and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you so many great rewards. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you abundance rewards. For that, my brothers in Islam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once again, he encourages us to fast 6 days in the month of Shawwal. The month of Shawwal that we've already experienced 3 days from that month. So fast those days and be steadfast and put yourself in the right environments that help you to be steadfast. If you really want to be steadfast, you need to choose. You need to choose your environments carefully. You need to be very selective who you hang out with. You need to be very selective who are the people that you want to associate yourself with. Because you only want to be from amongst those, or with those that will remind you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They connect you to Allah azza wa jal. They only get you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's also something that's very important for us, especially nowadays, especially in our day and age now. We need to have the right people around us. We need to surround ourselves with the right people that connect us to Allah Azza wa Jal. Those people that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes. Those friends, those righteous people, those righteous friends, those pious people and pious friends that remind us of Allah Azza wa Jal when we forget. They pick us up when we fall. They connect us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we disconnect. They are the type of people that you want to surround yourself with. There's no need for you to surround yourself with someone that disconnects you from Allah. There's no need for you to put yourself in an environment that only distances you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, my brothers in Islam, put yourself in the right environments. Choose your friends carefully. Choose your environments carefully. And choose the people that you want to be with carefully. Because according to your friends, is who you become, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. And Allah azza wa jalla says, أَلَخِلَّاهُ يَوْمَا إِذٍ بَعْضٌ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the best of friends in this world will turn against each other in the hereafter, except the muttaqeen, those who acquire taqwa, the taqwa that we've spoken about. Friends in this dunya, friends in this world will turn against each other. They'll even start turning and report each other, and they'll start turning against each other in this world and the hereafter. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, أَلَخِلَّاهُ يَوْمَ إِذٍ بَعْضٌ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ. They'll turn and become enemies towards one another. إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ, except those who fear Allah. So surround yourself with those who fear Allah. Maybe from their fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this will rub off on you. And this will help you to be someone that fears Allah azza wa jal. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who listen and hear and act upon what they listen and hear.
لا 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 لا